Several people asked me coming in the door this morning how I was doing, and I was pleased to get the inquiries and respond, I'm above ground. I awoke, like the rest of us. And so I put it to you, how are you doing? 10% of Lent has already passed us by. 4 days of the 40. But it's not too late to start over again. You're exempted from the Sundays, you know that. 6 weeks of 6 days, and the 4 days we've had this last week make 40. One of my favorite writers, and you probably have come across him too, is a man named Joseph Campbell, who writes about myth and unfolds and unravels these great stories that we have in Scripture, particularly in Genesis, particularly in today's story. How marvelous this story is to convey a truth. And what is the truth of the first reading? It's not even that they are mentioned by name, Adam and Eve. You notice that, huh? It says the man and the woman. Humanity, at one point in evolution of time, became aware of itself. Like the veil was lifted from their eyes. And they knew right and wrong, good and evil. But they partook of the fruit of the tree of good and evil and its knowledge. What a burden and what a gift. And consequent to that, we became aware of our mortality, that we all will die. That's what we acknowledged Ash Wednesday. And thank God that he forced them out of the garden before they would partake of the tree of life. That's a wonderful thing, too. That's what gets us here. This is the tree of life. St. Paul has a way of going from that Genesis story and telling us how we think we've lost something to how, through Jesus, we have gained something. That all of us are called to share in eternal life. So how are we to proceed during the next 36 days of Lent? The way we began it. With fasting, with prayer, with works of charity. These are the counterpoints to the temptations to which Jesus himself was subject. I don't know about you, but my favorite part of the day now is the pre-dawn. I can't lay in bed because my back bothers me after a while. And so I get up, and this morning it was about 5. To enjoy the quiet, to enjoy my time in prayer. And I have a schedule for it. It's my habit now. I like it because the TV's off. The noise of the street is diminished. Like I said, driving even here this morning at this time, you could roll bowling balls down the streets and not hit anything, except for those turning into the soccer fields down the way. So, deprivation of external stimulation is perhaps what is called for in our fasting. The second great temptation, and that Jesus, you see, the devil quotes scripture, and then Jesus quotes scripture back to him. Shall not test the Lord your God. And yet, all of us do, don't we? God works for us. No, we work for God. Sometimes we get it twisted. And then finally, the great one, pride. Purpose, ego, narcissism, whatever you want to call it, to realize that's not the way it is. That we're only one of, what, 7 or 8 billion people on the planet. And yet God knows us. And so I say to you this morning, don't lose hope. Find a way for yourself to unplug yourself from the internet, to turn the TV off, to keep the noise down, to enter into sometimes the silence. That's, I think, the purposeful reason of our beginnings of liturgy here in Lent. No formal procession, no fanfare, a look in. I also encourage you, in whatever capacity that you do it, whether it's rote prayer or reflection and reading, do not be afraid to enter into the conversation with God. This too is our practice during these 40 days. These things help us to find a reason and a purpose. Some people who, and I'm amazed at some of them, friends of mine, who had a great faith and somehow lost it. It can't be lost. To be thankful for the faith that serves us now, you and me. Gives me direction and purpose. Why am I here? What am I doing? Where am I going? Is this the end all and be all, this existence? No, but with what energy I have left to serve others, to do works of charity and kindness. To be scored? No. To be remembered? No. Just because we can. And it puts us in a proper relationship with the rest of humanity and existence. These things I offer to you for reflection because Christ went through these things. And through that, we all move to Easter. We all move to eternity. We all move to heaven. That's where we're called. But raise your consciousness as the man and the woman, the light bulb went on in their head in the Garden of Eden, that the light bulb continue to glow in our heads. Amen.